Now, a tailor charges 780 for every piece of shirt altered. That's very cheap. And 850 for every pair of pants altered. And last month, the tailor collected, wow, $8,103 from altering shirt and pant. For every 27 pieces of shirt, sort of clothes, 15 of them were shirts and the rest were pants. So how many were pants? 27 minus 15, you find number of pants, right? So this one is 27 minus 15, that will give us 12. So over here, right, do you see that this one is one set? Okay, so one set, right, would be 15 shirts and 12 pants. So we have to find out this set first. How much is in one set? Because after you find out one set, right, you find out the total amount, okay, and then you take this total divided by this amount, you find out how many sets there are altogether. So 15 shirts, right, will be 15 multiplied by 780 plus 12 multiplied by 850. Okay, so just throw this inside a calculator. Let's see what we're gonna get. Okay, where is my calculator? Okay, so 15 multiplied by 7.8. Okay, that will give us 117. Then we have 12 multiplied by 8.5, and that will give us 102. So if you add all this up together, you're gonna get $219. So one set of 15 shirt and 12 pants will cost this much. In total, he collected this much. So we take this one divided by this one to find out in total how many sets there are altogether. So I take 8103 divided by 219. So 8103 divided by 219, that will give me 37. Which means that in total there are 37 sets of 15 shirts and 12 pants. Now the question is asking, what's the total number of pieces of shirts and pants altered altogether? In one set, there are 15 plus 12, which is 27. So I have 37 sets. So total how many? 37 multiplied by 27. So 37 multiplied by 27, that will give me 999 pieces of clothes. Okay? So use this set method. So for parents who are watching this, right, this set method is very, very useful. So for this set, it's like a ratio. For every one set, it's 15 to 12. So you find one set first. Then you find the total divided by the price of one set, and then you get a number of sets. And number of sets multiplied by number of clothes, you're going to get the answer. So for this, will be very, very useful for a lot of students who are facing issues like that. So the moment you see this kind of sentence, right, use the set method. It's great. All right, done.